So this is section 2.2 of your book, and it is infinite square. Well, there is another name for this one, which you can write as particle in a box. And another name for this one is infinite potential. Well, all these names are actually depicting one topic in quantum mechanics, and we will study this thing today. Okay, first let's assume that if we consider that there is a box, and in that box we are having a particle. Now, what kind of particle this is, we are not restricting ourselves to some specific particles, but this is any particle, and this particle is in this box. Now this particle is not able to move out of the box. So at any point you can find this particle. It may be here, it may be here, there is no restriction on it where this particle will be. But if we reduce the dimensions of this box, if we reduce the dimensions of this box and we reach to a scale of few nanometers, then what will happen? That this particle will be something like, you cannot say that the particle is here or here or here. The particle probability will be at many places. It will be most probable somewhere, it will be less probable somewhere, and there will be some points in this box in which the particle will not be there, or the particle cannot be there. Similarly, the particle was earlier stationary when we were not having that, you can say, reduce the dimensions. But when we reduce the dimension, the particle cannot be stationary. It will always be in motion. So the earlier situation before reducing the dimension was classical mechanics, in which the particle was at defined positions. And then when we reduce the dimensions, we moved to the quantum mechanics. And this is the very first example that is the border between the classical mechanics and the quantum mechanics. So you reduce the dimensions, how much? Up to few nanometers. So the particle will also be of that dimensions. And then quantum mechanical effect starts here, and the particle become probabilistic. There are points where you will have no chance that this particle can be there. There are points where you can say that the particle will only be here if it will have this much energy. And if the particle will have another energy, it will be somewhere else, it will not be at that position. So these are our quantum mechanical effects. So we start with the quantum mechanical configuration. And quantum mechanical configurations are configurations so that we define for this particle that this is a particle. It is inside a well, and the well is such that a box or a well is such that on the walls of it we are having, okay, in this direction we are having potential, in this direction we are having x, then the box dimension are from 0 to a. The box dimension are from 0 to a. The walls of this are actually at a very high potential, and we say that the potential is infinite. Why we are considering infinite potential? Because the particle is not able to move to cross this barrier. So the reason for considering the infinite potential, then the particle remains inside this box. And further, the particle is very easily, means the particle is able to move easily inside this box, where the potential is equal to zero. Inside this box, the particle is experiencing no force, no potential. Means when potential is there, it will cause force. The negative gradient of potential is force. So when no potential is there, no force there on this particle, and the particle is free to move in this box. And under this configuration, we will now solve the Schrödinger wave equation, the earlier part that we discussed yesterday. So I will write that the potential is such that this is equal to zero if x point is less than a is greater than zero. If we are in this range, our potential is equal to zero. And the potential is infinite elsewhere or otherwise. The potential is infinite. And now we will solve the Schrödinger wave equation. You remember what was the Schrödinger wave equation? It was minus h bar square over 2m curly square sine over 30 x square plus v of sine is equal I h bar curly sine over curly t. This was the Schrödinger wave equation, and you remember that this sine was actually the big sine, and this sine is a function of this big sine is a function of x and g. So we are having two variables here. Now we have solved this equation, and we came to know that this sine x t is equal to sine of x e to the power minus I e t over h bar. We have written this solution, and this sine of x was the stationary solution, and this was the time dependent solution. So we combine them, and our final solution is this. Now, the sine of x, you know that for sine of x, we will have to solve the equation, which is when this sine is equal to the energy E, so minus h bar square over 2m d square sine. Now it is this sine by dx square plus v of sine equals E sine. This was our equation one earlier, the time independent, which was giving you stationary states. Okay, now we will solve this equation, and we will consider this geometry. If you remember, last time I told you that this equation can only be solved when we know the value of v, that what is v. So here we consider a geometry in which v is given to us. And now we will solve this equation. So for the range, we are interested in which range? We are interested in this range, because our box is actually this one. So we will write that for x less than a greater than 0, v of x is equal to 0, and this implies that our equation becomes minus h bar square over 2m d square sine over dx square and plus 0 is equal to e sine. Because the potential will come out to be 0 there, and we have now the equation like this, that d square sine over dx square, if I multiply this on the other side, 2m e over h bar square, and this is sine. Now let me solve this differential equation by supposing this thing equal to some constant. And let's say that k is a constant, and this is equal to 2me square root by h bar. This is the constant that I suppose. This k is actually the real number, our p equals h bar k, but here we are taking it only as a constant. Why I am taking it like this, the 2m square root in this? Because I want to write here k square, so that my solution will become easy. And with this supposition, I can write the d square sine over dx square is equal to minus k square sine. Now you know that this is a very simple second order differential equation, and the solution of this equation is sine as a function of x is equal to a sine kx plus b cos kx. Its solution is also coming out to be e to the power ikx, a e to the power ikx plus b e to the power minus ikx. Now the eikx we can convert back into cos kx and sin kx, so it's the same thing. The solution is the same, but according to this geometry we want to write this solution. When we will write for the free particle, then we will write that e to the power ikx form. This situation is a bound particle situation. Like you say that in hydrogen atom, electron is bound to the proton there. So it will remain there. It will remain there. Although that particle is bound under certain potential. Our this particle is not bound in this region, but bound as a whole in this region, right? It is free to move in this region because zero potential is there, and it is bound on the walls. It cannot go to the wall, it cannot go or cross the wall. So this is the general solution. This is the general solution. Now we will fit this solution according to our geometry. Because our geometry is having the boundary conditions or the limiting conditions. So this is a cloth. Now we will have to convert it into clothes by applying the geometry of our system.